Welcome to part 4 of our series of the renewal. And in this study, we will go ahead and we will read Psalms 81 verses 3 and understand the word Kadash. What does the word Kadash mean? Like I said at the beginning of the study, that we will not yet derive, but let the verses explain for itself what this word means, right? Because as we said, as we saw in Paleo Hebrew, there are no vowel points and a word cannot have three different meanings, isn't it? So the context will determine what this word means. So let's read Psalms 81 verses 3 to 4 once again. It says, blow a shofar in the Kadash, in the full moon, for the day of our festival. For this is a law for Yasharel, a right ruling of the Elohim of Yaqub. So we saw Kadash, H2318, means renew. Okay, and even as we say, you know, many people say New Testament. Okay, but is it a New Testament that we are following, or is it a renewed testament? So you need to ask yourself whether we are following a New Testament or a renewed testament, because when we read Hebrews chapter 8, okay, let's read Hebrews chapter 8. Okay, and verses 8 onwards, 7 onwards, sorry. For if the first covenant had been faultless, then no place would have been sought for a second. Verse 8, for finding fault with them, he says, see, the days are coming, says Yahuwah, when I shall conclude with the house of Yasharel and with the house of Yehuda a renewed covenant, not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers in the day when I took them by the hand to lead them out of the land of Mitzrayim, because they did not continue in my covenant, and I disregarded them, says Yahuwah. Because this is the covenant that I shall make with the house of Yasharel after those days, says Yahuwah, giving my laws in their mind, and I shall write them on their hearts, and I shall be their Elohim, and they shall be my people. And they shall by no means teach each one his neighbor and each one his brother, saying, know Yahuwah, because they all shall know me, from the least of them to the greatest of them. So now if you see the word over here in verse 8, which is renewed, it's the same word Kadasha, right? Kadasha can mean new. It can also mean renew, as we saw. It can also mean a month. Okay. Now, there are people who opt for a solar calendar. They say that Kadash means only month. It is not new. It is not renew. It means month. Okay. How absurd it will be if you read the same verse saying that for finding fault with them, he says, see, the days are coming, says Yahuwah, when I shall conclude with the house of Yasharel and with the house of Yehuda a monthly covenant. Isn't it absurd? So what is this meaning of this word renewed? So as you see here, even Yahusha, if you read Matthew chapter 26 verses 28, okay, when Yahusha lifted the cup of wine, and he said, for this is my blood of the renewed covenant, which is poured out for many for forgiveness of sins. Why do we take this word as renewed and not new? Because the covenant is the same. The testator is the same, who is Yahuwah himself. The speaker is the same, who is Yahuwah himself. The covenant is the same. Only thing is, people did not continue in the covenant because they were fleshly, they were carnal. So that is the reason Yahuwah is saying that I will make a renewed barayat, a kadasha barayat, with the house of Yasharel and with the house of Yehuda. And I will write my laws in their minds and in their hearts. So in our minds and in our hearts, the same covenant has been written. Earlier, it was not there on the mind or on the hearts. It was on stone. It came on tablets of stone. Now it is on our hearts and on our minds. So that is the same. The covenant is the same. The only thing is, it is now in the Ruach. It is in the spirit. Hallelujah. And if the it talks about the ministration of, if the ministration which came on stones was glorious, how much more the ministration of the Ruach? Hallelujah. So much as so that Moses covered his face because his face shone with the glory. So how much more the renewed covenant should be in Yahusha HaMashiach, who is the son of righteousness himself. When Yahuchanan saw him in Revelation chapter 1, he fell as a dead man because he couldn't just see. So that is the glorious covenant that Yahuwah makes through Yahusha HaMashiach with us. Hallelujah. So you see here that the word renewed fits in apt rather than a month, because that is the renewal that happens, as we saw in Sarah also. Sarah got a physical son, Isaac. People stopped there. No, sir, you can't stop there, because you need to look with the eyes of Yahuwah, because he was looking at the stake, at the cross, the time of life when he would meet us at the appointed time to give us life, to make the barren womb fruitful, to bring the sons of promise. The whole creation groans in pain for the revealing of the sons of Elohim, Romans chapter 8. Hallelujah. Let's read Jeremiah chapter 31, verses 31. It says, see, the days are coming, declares Yahuwah, when I shall make a renewed covenant, same word, kadash, covenant with the house of Yisrael and with the house of Yehuda. So the word kadash, which is H2319, is the same as H2318, which means renewed. So the shofar, when we come back to Psalms chapter 81 verses 3, when it had to be blown, it had to be blown in the renewal. So what renewal, what renews apart from the moon? Have you seen the phases of the moon? The new moon, how does the new moon look? Let me show it to you. Let's see a picture of a new moon. Okay. This is how a new moon looks. Can you see this? It's a dark shadow. There's nothing else to see. And the first crescent that appears is the renewal. And then the renewal goes on happening until it comes to the point where it is a full moon. Until it comes to a point when it is a full moon. This is a full moon. Kasa, the same word kasa, which is used in Psalms chapter 81 verses 3. See here, let's get back. Psalms 81 verses 3. Blow the shofar in the kadash, in the full moon, kasa, H3677. Let's look at H3677 again. Kasa, the full moon. There are only two occurrences of this word, full moon. Okay, and the latest translation also translated as covering, something that is clothed with. So the word H3680 means to clad self, close, clothe, conceal, cover, hide. So that is the word, means kasa. And kasa comes from the root word kas. Kas means to cover. It's like a cup which is covered. It's like a seat which is covered, something that is concealed, something that is hidden. Hallelujah. Now you will be surprised to see, Revelation chapter 12. Let's turn to Revelation chapter 12. It says, and a great sign was seen in heaven, a woman clad, which means clothed, with the sun, with a moon under her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. So who's this woman? Who's clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and a head of on her head a crown of 12 stars. This woman is New Jerusalem, who's clothed with the sun of righteousness, who is Yahusha HaMashiach himself. And the moon is the covering. She's covered. Her feet are covered. She has got light to walk. Your word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Let's continue in the next part.